Nadasha Boland. 17 is Caitlin Blevins. And 25 is Emma Russell. Ferreira 3, Cardoza 6, Augustine 12, Boland 15, Blevins 17, Russell 25. And here we go the other way. Nice layup. And that's number 18, Carly Numberg, with the layup and score. I'll read the white here. I will read you the white roster here momentarily. And 2-2, good game. Starting to cool off. Beautiful weather right now. We had a warm summer day. But the weather with the shade now, it's really comfortable, so I expect the athletes to have a good game. Singh goes coast-to-coast with the left hand, just rolls off the front rim. With that, good time to announce, tell you the white. 7 is Molly Shuey. 9 is Cameron Singh. 10 is Peyton Bartnack. 12 is Tenley Messersmith. 16 is Cameron Blevins. And 18, Carly Numberg. And Singh with the steal, going full court off the glass. Just a little bit strong. Nice rebound. Numberg had the offensive rebound. Didn't go. New Shuey ends up with it on the outside. Swings it around. Shot is up. And Singh shading her eyes. She might have been looking right in the sun. That angle is right about right in the sun. The sun is behind us to the left. So on the basket here on the left, the sun might be a factor. You can kind of tell by the sun on the courts and the shadow. So. Oh, it's a little something playing outside, a little bit of a challenge. For the most part, the outdoor court's in very good shape, very good shape. If this is your first game taken in from a summer camp, we are located at the Sierra Outdoor Camp, just east of Sonora. Singh with the layup, a little bit strong. Emma Russell comes down with the rebound, pushes it up. Nice pivot in there. We've spent a lot of time pivoting, so the campers start to see them pivoting more when they play. We're going to have a jump ball. 2-2 here, really to go. First half, 15 minutes running time. There are no timeouts, so coaches are not allowed to call a timeout the first half. We do take 2 TV timeouts, so at the 10-minute mark, we'll take a TV timeout. And at the 5-minute mark, we'll take a TV timeout. So the coaches get 2 automatically. There's a rebound to the orange. Boland drives. Nice pass there. Ferreira, good ball movement. Cardoza on the baseline. It looks like it was knocked out of bounds, but White's going to end up with it, come the other way. Blevins in front. Nice jump stop. Block from behind by Boland. Boland did a wonderful job coming, getting back in the play. She was on the far side, on the far corner, and hustled all the way back to come in and make a block on that play. Now she's setting a screen for her team. Cardoza dribbling, trying to size things up. Nice pass to Boland. Nice running layup for 2. Boland with the score. And Cardoza with the assist. 4-2. And we have a timeout on the court. So with 9:42 left to go, we'll take a first timeout. 4-2, Lancaster in front. You are watching NorCal Sports TV and the NorCal Sports TV Summer Camp. We're back. Sorry about that. I was tripping over my headphones there. Literally. NorCal Sports TV Team Camp, Lynx, and these Sparks. 4-2, the Lynx are out in front. That's Madison Cardoza with the steal. Ball is knocked away. Orange rosters, Jillian Ferreira 3, Madison Cardoza 6. 12 is Adelina Augustine. 15, Nadeja Bolin. 17, Caitlin Blevins. And 25, Emma Russell. That's Cardoza. Cardoza to Blevins. Back to Cardoza. Over to Russell. Russell drives the top. She's got a lane. Thought she was going to pull out. Oh, nice idea. Good pass across. Cardoza. Russell runs to the baseline, gets it, and hits the 15-footer. Nice shot. 6-2. So Russell, and you'll see Russell everywhere. She, the last game we watched with her, she was all over the court, diving for loose balls, playing hard. And Singh answers right back. Cameron Singh with the bucket. 6-4 Lynx. Sparks are in the white. Teams are playing man-to-man as per NorCal TV Sports Camp rules. Teams do play man-to-man the entire game, except for the last 2 minutes. Teams are allowed to press or zone or mix it up, but only the last 2 minutes. During the week, campers are working on man-to-man principles. And as an old coach, we know that zone is usually, even in zone, you're going to want to learn some man-to-man principles to be able to match up with your opponents. So it's really important to learn man-to-man base defensive principles. Blevins with the shot didn't go. Cardoza with the rebound. Campers today in particular were working on boxing out, so you may see some boxing out inside. Russell drives, may have been fouled and scored. So Russell with another bucket. 8-4. Emma Russell. Emma is from Copperopolis. And there goes Cameron Blevins. So Blevins answers 8-6. I thought this game might be a high-scoring affair. It's, the weather's nice. All the campers had dinner at 5. A little bit cooler. Nice pass inside. Russell decides to pull it out. Nice little hesitation move, turn, and bucket. So Emma Russell. With another bucket. Blevins goes. Blevins with a nice pass behind her. To Molly Shuey, and there's going to be a foul call. We're going to shoot a pair, it looks like. Molly is listed as 6'4", and she's from Chico. So we have a few of our campers are from Chico this week. Number 9, Cameron Singh, is also from Chico. So shout out to all those people watching us from Chico, home of the Chico State Wildcats. Wildcats themselves have some excellent basketball teams. Greg Klink coaching the men. Brian Fogel coaches the women. Dewey's second is up and good. Nice follow through. Nice bucket. 10-7. Lynx out in front. Cardoza catches it on the wing. Back to Russell. Russell drives right. And that was knocked out of bounds. Russell was feeling it. Looked like she thought she had the corner. She was going baseline. Ball was poked away from behind. Russell will take it out of bounds. Blevins is over there on the left. Sneaky. Oh, nice. Singh got back to make the block. Master Smith goes full court. Might have taken an extra step. Wasn't quite sure what to do. And with 5:05 left to go, we'll take our second TV timeout. You're watching NorCal Sports Television and the NorCal Sports Television Team Camp. Excuse me.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far? My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought there was going to be like very little people here from all around here, but there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just got to meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people.
Welcome back, family and friends, basketball enthusiasts. NorCal Sports TV Summer Camp, Junior NBA Division game between the Lynx and the Orange, and the Sparks and the White. Lynx are leading 10-7. A reminder, you can buy highlight tapes, highlight videos of each of our campers. They are on the website, NorCalSportsTV.com. So, parents, you may want to look into that. Lots of good moments. We've had lots of great, actually, action with all the games, and you may find that those highlights videos are something that you can share for many years, and it might be fun to look back on later in the year, or maybe a few years down the road when these girls are in high school or perhaps playing in college, or who knows, perhaps playing in the WNBA. You never know. That ball is taken by Shuey. She looks to go. Pull up. Nice pull up. Kicks it to Singh. Thought about a three. Back to Shuey. Shuey drives. Baseline. Got it. Molly Shuey, who likes to drive left. 10-9. Cardoza gets it out there on the far wing. Back to Russell. Carly Nunberg deflected that. Blevins goes for a layup. Looks like it was blocked. Might have been some contact in there. Pass up. Oh, nice drive, Messersmith. This time with the floater, gets the roll. Floater off the glass, hung on that front rim and dropped. And the Sparks now, four unanswered points, have jumped out to an 11-10 lead. These two teams played earlier, and it was a one-point game, so I would expect this to be another game that goes down to the wire. That was Jillian Ferreira with the shot that was blocked out of bounds. Jillian is from here in Sonora, so hello to all you watching from down the hill in Sonora. We have a few parents here tonight. A few parents have creeped in. See some families, friends here this evening. Camp is ongoing until Friday. Friday is the tournament. Messersmith again drives off the glass a little bit hard. Singh gets the rebound. Pulls up again to Shuey. Shuey drives. Bowling called for the foul. Looks like Nadesha had a lot of ball there, but that's a call. So we'll shoot two. Molly's first one is up and a little bit strong. You may notice Molly has an excellent follow through. Takes two dribbles, just a little bit long, but those are right on. As she gets older and gets a little stronger, she's going to become an excellent free throw shooter, no doubt. No doubt with that good form. Ball's knocked away. Again, 11-10, if you're just joining us. The Lynx are in the orange. The Sparks are in the white. And Bolin answers. So Nadesha comes right back with a bucket of her own, and it's 12-11. These two teams are staying close to each other this evening with a minute 22 to go. Been a very clean game. Had some nice offensive moves. Singh takes a little spin. Might have been deflected. Official says no, we'll go the other way. Russell dribbles it up. Cardoza looked like she was setting a screen, but Ferreira sets a screen. Nice pass inside. Short baseline shot doesn't go. Cardoza runs it down. Nice rebound. Back to Russell, and that's stolen. Messersmith read that well, anticipated. Might have had a team out on the wing, but she holds it. Huey will take it, goes strong. And we have a block. Blocking call. So the Lynx Sparks will take it out underneath. Numberg inbounds it. Peyton Bartnick runs it down for the White. Peyton dribbles it up. She may go all the way. Let's see. Pulls up. And going to be called for a travel. 10 seconds to go. Let's see if the Orange can get a shot up. Ball goes into Russell. Russell might take it full court. And that's the half. We played one. And the Lynx are on top 12-11. You are watching NorCal Sports TV and the NorCal Sports TV Summer Camp. We'll be back after a few short messages with the second half. Welcome back, family, friends, basketball enthusiasts, basketball junkies, and everyone watching us on NorCal Sports TV. This is the second half of the NorCal Sports TV matchup between the Lynx and the Sparks, and that was a nice shot there by Nadeja Bolin, I believe. And Lynx 14-11. Shuey dribbles to the left. Lynx are in orange. Sparks are in white. That was a nice drive by Tenley Messersmith. Didn't drop. Orange is looking to run. Bolin pushes it up. Crosses over to her left. Oh, nice. Found Russell open. Russell on the wing. Doesn't go. Nice rebound. A little bit too strong. Russell and Blevins fighting in there. Whistle ball's going to go to the white. Sparks. Sparks are coached by Kiara Maripol. Let me read them for you real quick. 7 is Molly Shuey. 9 is Cameron Singh. 10 is Peyton Bartnick. 14, Tenley Messersmith. 16 is Cameron Blevins. And 18 is Carly Numberg. The Sparks are coached by Kiara Maripol. Kiara herself went to Lincoln High School out of Stockton, not too far. Hour and a half, 2 hours west of here. Down the hill and west. Emma almost got away with the travel, but they're going to call it travel there. The Lynx, the orange, Jillian Ferreras, number 3, Madison Cardoza, 6, 12, Adelina Augustine, Nadeja Bolin is 15, Caitlin Blevins, 17, 25 is Emma Russell, and the Lynx are coached by Joya Armstrong. Joya currently plays for Stanislaus State, which is also about an hour and a half, 2 hours down the hill from us, a little bit further to the south. And Joya is a Vanden Viking alum. There's a rebound, Cardoza. Oh, it didn't go. Good effort. Emma just does all the dirty work. Emma got on the ground. Nice pass, didn't go, but great work by Emma Russell. 14-11. Back to Joya. She attended Vanden High School. And years ago, I was an assistant coach at Vanden High School. I won't tell you how many years ago, but it was a long time ago. Under the great Jim Boyd, legendary Jim Boyd. Blevins pulls up shot. Nice. That was about 18 feet out there. Caitlin Blevins. And the Lynx are feeling it. 16-11 over the Sparks. With 12:04 left to go here in the second half. Cameron Blevins drives. She's trying to make something happen inside. Might have lost it momentarily. Looking for a teammate. Finds Numberg, Carly Numberg, cross. Messersmith has it. Nice possession. Everybody touched the ball. Peyton Bartnick has it. Back to Shuey. Shuey drives. And we have a foul. So I believe we're going to shoot two. Molly Shuey. Molly is listed at 5'4". Molly's shot is up and good. 16-12. Like the confidence. Second one is up and good. So Molly hits them both. Lynx. Drive. Answer by Emma Russell. Emma answers right back. Both teams playing some solid offense today. We're seeing both teams finish a little bit more. Blevins tried to drive, might have taken that a little bit too far. With 10:20 to go. White's going to inbound it. Numberg inbounds to Shuey. And we'll take our first TV timeout of the second half. Right now the Lynx are out on top 18-13 over the Sparks. And you are watching NorCal Sports TV summer camp basketball action. family and friends, basketball enthusiasts. You're watching NorCal Sports TV and the NorCal Sports TV Summer Camp coming to you from the Sierra Outdoor School just east of Sonora. Jeremy Hurtado with us producing. Jeremy also does some announcing, so he is a busy guy today. And we all are. It's been a heck of a week. Two more days. Full day tomorrow. Friday, a half day of camp. Featuring a tournament Friday that determines camp champions. Links with the ball here. Moving right to left on your screen. Links are in the orange. Nice passing there. Blevins gets it down low. Pulls out for a shot and a little bit strong. But Emma Russell runs it down. Russell to Nadeja Bolin. That's a nice looking play. 2013. Russell filling up the stat category. Ran down that rebound and kicked it back to Nadeja for the assist. Singh with the runner doesn't go. Nice outlet by the Lynx. Blevins runs it down. Sparks did a good job of getting back. But there's a pass inside. Ball is knocked around. Singh thought she had it. Bolin and Singh kind of battling for that ball. Bolin ends up with it. She looks deep, trying to hit Blevins. Oh, nice pass and catch. Didn't quite go, but Carly Nunberg is there to follow. So 20-15. Nice transition offense that time by the Sparks. Outlet pass through a dime. Blevins ran it down, and Nunberg was able to follow. That ball knocked out of bounds. I believe it's going to stay here with the Lynx. 20-15. We'll have two more games for you this evening. Let me rephrase that. There'll be two sets of games. So actually, you'll have six more games. But there's two more games coming this evening. The 7:40 and 8:30 game. Blevins dribbles up. Blevins goes behind the back. Drives down that left-hand lane. Ran into a little bit of traffic. Some nice dribbling there. Fancy dribbling. Here comes the Lynx. Nice pass. Nice finish. Oh, doesn't go. Rebound. Pass. Nunberg brings it down, and she's going to go coast to coast. Doesn't make it. Carly did everything right, just didn't quite finish. And here goes Russell the other way. Russell surveying the floor, looking for someone to pass to. Jammed in the corner. Let's see what she does to get herself out of trouble. Looking, 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 looking. And that's going to be a five-second call. Once you're dribbling and pick up the ball, you only have 5 seconds to pass before it's called a violation. Most of the times the refs gives you a little bit longer. It's more like a 5.5 or 6. Emma just got herself stuck in the corner. Blevins has it on the outside. That's Cameron Blevins. She drives to her right. Passes it to Singh. Singh with a little move to the right. Good help defense. Back to Blevins. A little bit strong. Nuremberg with the rebound just off. Orange is going to outlet it. Doesn't quite catch it clean. Messersmith picks up the loose ball. Ball is tied up. Let's see. I believe that's going to stay with the white this time. And I had it wrong. Five fifty left. Russell pulls it to Bolin. Didn't get the roll. Offense looking much better, much cleaner, even as we watch the teams progress throughout the week. The shot's looking nice. Nice little dump pass there to Singh, a little strong. Blevins, I like to call that a dump pass. It's a little low, easy pass to your teammate right about the west so they can catch and score. Russell with some good footwork. I thought she might have slipped there. Got her balance. Bolin for a three. Got it. Boom. The Deja Bowling from downtown, 23-15. Lynx are in front. We will take our last television break. You are watching NorCal Sports Television Summer Camp.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought there's gonna be like very little people here from all around here, but there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just got to meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new.
TV Sports Summer Camp. Lynx and Sparks. Lynx are on front 23-15. These two teams played earlier this afternoon and the Sparks were victorious by one. So the Lynx were determined to have a different outcome the second game, and right now they're leading by eight with 4:40 to go. There will be two future NorCal Sports TV summer camps in July. The first one begins July 11th. I should say the second camp begins July 11th, and the third camp begins Monday, July 18th. Check that out on NorCalSportsTV.com. Also, you can find highlight films available, so family members, you may want to check out the highlight videos available. That you can also find them on NorCalSportsTelevision.com. And Adelina Augustine with the bucket. 25-15. Blevins dribbles on the far side. To her right. Looking to make something happen. Little runner doesn't quite go. And that looks like it's going to be off of white. And orange ball. Lynx ball. Not only do we have games later, but there's a knockout competition. There's a three-point competition later this evening. Cardoza catches it and drives. Might have got away with an extra step there. Ball is poked away. Singh on the defense there. Singh rips it away. Looking to go full court by herself out in front. Oh, didn't quite convert. She was coming at a tough angle, a little too straight. Sometimes a little bit of an angle helps you. And Blevins might have got away with an extra step. However, Caitlin buries the jumper, and it's 27-15. The Lynx struggled a little bit earlier today, but this evening they are playing excellent. Numberg steals that away, doesn't go. It's been a busy day for the campers. Clinics in the morning. Games and knockout games, and specific knockout games and hotspot games. Hotspot are where the players shoot from five spots for a variety of point totals. Blevins, oh, nice crossover, spin, bucket. Some excellent dribbling there by Cameron Blevins. Started to her right, went left, and then had a little scoop layup. 27-17. Both these teams have really progressed during the week. In particular on the offense, Cardoza looked like she traveled on that. 1:47 to go. Blevins brings it up. Can size it up. Oh, good hands. Good hands by Augustine. Ball comes to me. Here we go. I'm in the game again. There you go. One thirty to go. Last 2 minutes. The clock is stopped, so sometimes that could be a challenge for the officials when you've been running clock the whole game. So now we'll play running clock. The clock will be stopped on fouls. Players will shoot one-on-ones if fouled, if not a shooting foul. Shui travels, kicks it out to Blevins, kicks it to Singh. Nice offense, nice shot, a little bit strong. Rebound by Augenstein, who's had a nice second half here. Cardoza is trapped. And bucket doesn't go. That was Number with the steal. And Carly can't believe it. That's about her third layup this game that has just not gone down. In the old days, we would say there's a lid on the basket. Ball remains with White. Pass goes inside. Shuey didn't convert. There's a lot of bodies, a lot of traffic. That's at the far end from us. Also a little bit of shade down there. Nice pass to Blevins. Little runner. Good. We got a steal and a bucket. Coach Armstrong's going to take a timeout. 27-21. 49 seconds to go. We'll be back here watching NorCal Sports Television Summer Camp. Seconds to go. Lynx and the Sparks. The Lynx are out on top 27-21. The Sparks have just rolled off 4 points in a row. The last 2 minutes, teams are allowed to press. So it can make the games a little bit chaotic. I guess I should say chaotic if you're ahead, a little bit fun and exciting if you're behind. So Orange will be inbounding. 49 seconds to go. 27-21. Russell is inbounding. You get 5 seconds to inbound. It gets it to Bolin. Bolin dribbles up. Brings it across the timeline. Nice job. Might see the White come trap or double team. Bolin going left. Excellent job handling pressure there. Russell has it. Picks up the ball. 30 seconds. Knocked away. 29 seconds here to go. 27-21. Lynx are thinking if we can just get it in, spend a little time, we're in good shape. White's thinking if we can get a steal, we got a chance. And Singh comes up with one. But Blevins almost gets it back, but the White gets it through. Number doesn't go, but Sui was there and just couldn't convert. 19 seconds to go. Oh, the Sparks had a chance. That was some great defense, but didn't quite pull it off. Cardoza gets it. She's going to go. She might go all the way. Cardoza dribbles to the baseline. Might have got away with an extra step. Here we go. Blevins. 7 seconds left. 5, 4. And that's going to do it. So the Lynx hang on. Defeat the Sparks. 27-21. That avenges an earlier loss from this afternoon. So, again, it was the Lynx 27, Sparks 21. This is Brian Fonseca. I've enjoyed being with you. producer Jeremy Hurtado. You are watching NorCal Sports TV and the NorCal Sports Summer Camp. Reminder, you can check out highlight films are available on the NorCalSportsTV.com website. And plenty of action left. We will see you later.